Antibodies imitating coronavirus may explain long COVID, study says. Around 256 million cases and more than 5 million deaths, COVID-19 has laid waste worldwide, and it hasn't finished delivering. Scientists are struggling to stop the suffering of survivors from long COVID. But before we continue, please like this video if you find this informative and subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative content. Don't forget to click the bell icon too to get the latest updates. According to the British Heart Foundation, long COVID is a term for COVID-19 effects that persist weeks or months after the initial illness. It can happen to anyone who contracted the coronavirus, regardless of their symptoms. So even those who have no symptoms may be at risk of long COVID later. The main problem with long COVID is the lack of a specific treatment, and the reason for that is the mystery of the condition itself. How did it happen in the first place? At the University of California, Davis, researchers investigated what is going on inside a body that may explain long COVID. Their efforts yielded surprising results, which should demand more research. Researchers explained that when the coronavirus attacks healthy cells, the immune system ramps up to create and release antibodies. During the initial infection, the immune system releases protective antibodies to disable the virus and infected cells. Later on, the same antibodies will trigger a new response but toward themselves. These secondary antibodies are called anti-ideotype antibodies. With their configuration, anti-ideotypes may act like the original antigen targeted by neutralizing antibodies. Here's the situation. After the infection has been dealt with, protective antibodies and anti-ideotypes interact with each other as a form of downregulation. The result should be the clearance of the first protective antibodies. What happens if something goes wrong? It may lead anti-ideotypes to target the same ACE2 receptors desired by the coronavirus. Imagine healthy cells having their ACE2 blocked or triggered by these antibodies. That meaningless trigger may cause different normal ACE2 functions to go wonky. The malfunction may explain why some survivors still feel COVID symptoms. While not concrete yet, the findings offer another explanation for long COVID. It is an alternative to other studies that speculate remnants of the coronavirus causing extended damage to organs. What do you think of the findings? Do you believe that specific antibodies may be going wild after the initial infection? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.